Hey guys, I'm Abby and welcome to day 8 of the 15-day songwriting challenge. We are more than halfway done with this challenge now, and today we're going to be talking about putting lyrics to music. If you're new here, please subscribe and you can download the free template in the description to help you with your writing. If you're over on Patreon, then you can download the extra templates and resources there as well. So first we're going to talk about some broad questions that you want to answer. So take a look at what your text is asking for musically, see what type of mood it's trying to address. So back at the beginning of this challenge, you guys wrote down a whole bunch of text. Go ahead and read through that again and see what kind of mood is there, what kind of feeling it's trying to capture. And then after you've answered those questions, you can figure out some answers to these broad questions about music. So the first thing that you want to ask yourself is if you want your piece to be in a major or a minor key. So really broad generalization is that major keys are more for happy songs and minor keys are more for sad songs. And then another question you can ask yourself is if you want this song to be fast or slow. And again, it's really general, but fast and upbeat songs are for happy songs, and then slow would be more for a sad song. And then the last thing that you can ask yourself about like a broad generalized topic is if you want this to be a loud song or a soft song. So with a loud song, you might have the full band, it's more intense. With the soft, it might just be you and a couple other people, and it'll be a little sweeter and softer. And then the last thing that you can ask yourself is if you want to maybe juxtapose some of these ideas. So maybe you have a sad breakup song, but you want it to be sarcastic, so you're gonna add some upbeat and happy kind of music. That's kind of a fun thing to do. Then you can also think about what kind of chord progression might be best suited for your music. So if you have a lot of text, if there's a really big story to tell and it's really important for your listener to hear what you're saying, then you might want to keep the harmonies more simple. If there's a lot going on in the harmonies, it might be distracting for the listener, and if there's less going on, if it's more simple, then they're gonna more easily be able to focus in on the lyrics. Another thing you can think about is if you have one or two harmonies, you keep it really simple, then you could possibly create kind of a really peaceful sound for the listener as well. If there's not a whole lot of movement in the harmonies, it creates this kind of static atmosphere, which can be really nice depending on what you're trying to say in the song. Also, if you use only one or two harmonies, but there's one spot in the song that you really want to highlight, then you can use a different harmony in that section to bring out that part. And it'll stand out a lot since the rest of the song is only one or two harmonies. If it's less of a big deal for your listener to understand all the lyrics, then go ahead and throw in some more complex harmonies. Make it fun with the harmonies if you want to. In terms of your melody, you can think of if there are any important words in the text that you want to highlight. And when you write your melodies, at this part, you could put a jump in the melody, you could make the note go up high, and you can stretch it out. And that's gonna bring out certain words more. You can kind of think about how we talk. When you emphasize certain words, that's kind of like your melody too, when you emphasize words, but you do it with your pitch and with how long you stay on that note. Be careful with what words you highlight. Make sure you're not emphasizing anything that's unimportant, like maybe the word the. And then another thing you can think about with your melodies is which syllables in the text you want to highlight. Some really nice syllables for singing are ah and oh, and so those are nice words to emphasize. And you can try to avoid emphasizing words with the vowel sounds e and the consonants, because those are less pleasant to listen to. And then the last thing I want to talk about is word painting, which is a really cool thing. It's when the music is directly influenced by what you're saying in the lyrics. So let's say in your text you have the word stop, and then you sing the word stop, and then the whole music stops. So the music is literally reflecting what the lyrics are saying. Another example would be if you sing the word high, and then the melody goes up high. Or if you sing the word low, the melody goes down low. So you can also use word painting in your instrumental parts as well. So let's say you're talking about rain in your text, then in the piano part, maybe you could play something like bloop, 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 and it sounds like a musical interpretation of rain. Or maybe you're talking about birds in your song, and on the guitar, you can play a little bird call. You can also do this with mixing. So there's a Billie Eilish song where she sings the word underwater, and the EQ changes, so it sounds like she's actually singing underwater. And then you can also use word painting in a broad sense over the whole song. There is a John Mayer song called Stop This Train, where he's slapping the guitar throughout, and it sounds like chugga, 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 chugga. So it actually sounds like a train moving. There is also a classical song by Franz Schubert called Der Erlkönig, which is about a father and a son riding on a horse, and you can hear the horse galloping in the piano part throughout the whole song as well. So this is kind of a fun and creative thing to do if your music calls for it. And it's not creating the sound literally, whatever you're trying to imitate, it's more of a musical interpretation of that sound. So think about if your song could use anything like this. So your assignment for today is to think about what kind of mood your lyrics are trying to express and what kind of music might fit best for that. So think about if you want your song to be in major or minor, if it should be fast or slow, loud or soft, and think about if you want your chord progression to be more simple or a little more complex. Think if there are any important words that you can highlight in the melody or in the chord progression, and think about if there are any opportunities to use some word painting, either in specific spots or throughout the whole song. So you can download the free template in the description to help you with your writing, and if you're over on Patreon, you can download the extra templates and resources there. Let us know in the comments what you're planning to do, and let us know if you can think of any other popular songs with word painting, because I think that would be really helpful for people to hear. Please like the video and subscribe. Tomorrow we're finally gonna start talking about sections in the songs. We're gonna be talking about how to write a verse. So I will see you then. Have a good time writing. Bye.